ex-president of the Producers Guild and founder of Vishesh Films. He makes more films than other people make. Kulmeet Makkar, CEO of the Producers Guild of India. And Neeraj Goswami, Senior Vice President, Distribution, Viacom. Ladies and gentlemen, there's a whole bunch of stuff that you're going to hear today. I'm not going to waste your time talking about it. I'm not the expert. I would like for Ranjit to start. Thank you. And yes, after all of them have finished speaking, I will throw the house open in case you want questions and answers. I will have questions definitely as a producer. Thank you. Hello everybody, good evening. Thank you all for being here. My name is Ranjit Thakur from Crayon Media. I'd just like to share a few thoughts, take you back down memory lane before I speak about the plan that we are about to unfold and what we want to accomplish. Way back in June 2005, there was DCI formed. DCI was a core committee represented by all the major studios in Hollywood to set the standard for digital cinema and the architecture for it, meant to be followed across the globe. Then, few months later, came the magical day of 4th November 2005, when a film from Disney called Chicken Little had its first commercial digital screening in Burbank, California. The first viewers had actually mixed reactions. Some were extremely mesmerized that how could an image like this be on screen without the 35mm celluloid print. While some thought, oh, the colors are not warm, resolution was much to be desired, so on and so forth. Of course, digital cinema has evolved leaps and bounds technologically from back in the day to where we are today. But the one thing that stuck to everyone's mind is that, oh, here digital is here to stay. It will clearly replace the 35mm print that we've been using for years and years together. Mind you, they had just seen the transition of camera from the camera roll, earlier camera reel to digital camera. So this was obvious that it's meant to stay. Coming back to today's day in Mumbai and about our digital cinema plan, what am I here and what am I trying to establish? I want to speak about my vision and what we are here to accomplish. Is that the whole digital gamut in the country should benefit the industry at large and all stakeholders in the business. This is purely my vision. We may agree to disagree in some cases, but this is really how I would see digital cinema position. Let's categorize all the stakeholders and see what's the benefit to each one of them. First is our esteemed lot of producers. Historically, if you see, the producers never funded any piece of projection or sound equipment that the cinema ever installed. That was a cost that the cinema had to bear on their side. Recently, the cinema never funded any production cost that was there on the production side. They had purely had a revenue share agreement on a certain film rental on a movie-to-movie basis. Now comes the digital cinema revolution, where it's meant to benefit everybody. Speaking from the producer's perspective, the producer is already contributing, the participating producer in this case is already contributing his pound of flesh for the digital cinema conversion by paying the VPF for an agreed period of time once for that piece of equipment and for that particular location. There have been instances and misconceptions that we've had examples of that around the world. I'll give you a very small example. I have some of my friends who are manufacturers of digital equipment in the audience today. And you will ask everybody, they will tell you that the average life of a digital projector is 15 years, give or take, roughly. So let's say what happens when we have a VPF plan and the cost of equipment is recouped. What happens when the equipment needs upgrade? What happens when the equipment needs a change? That's definitely on the dime of the exhibitor. And really, the participating producer in this case being the last beneficiary of a zero digital release, which is his due right because he's participated in the program, should not be held responsible to pay for that. Then comes a scenario where a property transitions one owner to another. classic example, down the road we have Fun Cinemas, which transitioned into being Cinepolis. Now, if this gentleman here was a produce participating producer in the plan, do you expect that after this term of VPF, or whatever term has been agreed upon by all the industry personnel, you expect him to pay again? Because now the equipment and the property went to Cinepolis, which was earlier owned by Fun. I personally don't think so. I think that's not fair. So the one thing that I want to make clear is that the transition to digital and the participating producer paying a VPF has to be done only once in a lifetime. I would go beyond and say that in the lifetime use of that equipment and perpetual use of that particular property being a commercial cinema should not warrant paying a second VPF. That's the way I would look at it and how VPF would benefit the producers. The one thing that is true for India, that we are the only country, pretty much that I think so, is giving content, production is giving content to a non-DCI platform. Out of every country in the world that at least I am aware of. Yes, it was circumstantial. I personally don't have anything against any non-DCI player or anybody in the stakeholder or people who are running their business for whatever they think is appropriate. They have all rights to do so. But what I'm saying is I urge the producers to think long term. Yes, there will be, we are a country where it has a tier 2, tier 3 market. There are different sizes of theaters where box office collections are vary from something to something completely different. But what I urge the producers, don't look at it as on a minute basis on a property to property. Take a bird's eye view, see the overall benefit that they're getting on the release. And at the end of the day, when they're going to stop paying VPF, irrespective of property, the savings on the VPF will add straight to the bottom line, which is very large. Today's cost of release, depending on, of course, the box office fate, could be anywhere between 10 to 30% of the release cost. That's really covering all the benefits of the production side. Coming back to our exhibitor friends. Yes, there are affordability issues. People don't have the capital to go and buy a DCI compliant projector. There comes a role for integrators like ourselves. However, at the end of the day, think of a scenario, why would you agree to rent a piece of equipment forever? I mean, do we do that with any other asset that we know of? Not in my knowledge at least. So if you have a piece of asset that you know your livelihood depends upon and you're going to use that for many, many years to come, you'd at some point of time want to own it. Rightly so. Everything is value driven because the exhibitor had a certain cost of a 35 millimeter film which he was otherwise paying. Now there's a digital cost, there is X, this is Y, there's a cost difference, cost increase as a matter of fact, we all recognize that. But he can't be penalized to pay that rent forever. So at some point, as per the terms of the arrangement with all the stakeholders, the title of that equipment needs to belong to him, very clearly, after which he doesn't owe a buck on that piece of equipment to anybody in the world. Second being, the advent of digital, I think, has expanded the horizon of all the advertisement revenues and the possibilities that have on the digital cinema space from an exhibitor's perspective. He absolutely has all right to retain that. I don't think it's fair for him to not have that pound of flesh because on one fine day he did not have money to buy that piece of equipment. The plan that we have is that we want to consolidate all the mom and pop exhibitors, the small time tier 2, tier 3, combine that. Only act as agents, or so to say, he could pretty much go to any consolidator of advertisement who keeps a 20-30% share of the revenue that he otherwise sells and passes the bulk of that portion to the exhibitor. That's currently not today as far as the Indian industry is concerned. So look at it from his side on a holistic approach. So if he owned the equipment over a certain time, he paid rent, he got absolutely the best service that he deserves. There's no downtime on equipment. He got his content in a timely manner. He got his KDMs. Everything in a perfect world is good. He owned the equipment. He got the advertisement. Post the term, he doesn't have to pay a rent. Neither does he have to pay anybody a share of the advertisement. Even an agency, if he desires not to. That's a prerogative that he has. Within this space, there comes an integrator like us who says, okay, in my plan that we have today, that we are, Kriyan is unfolding, we have a set mark, then we will only retain 30% of all the revenues consolidated of the ads that we have accumulated among the participating exhibitors. That ad revenue is increasing exponentially on a year-on-year basis. There are listed companies who are our exhibitor friends, PVR, Inox. The actual amount of revenue, you'll be surprised, from advertisement is as high as between 35 lakhs to 45 lakhs per screen per year. That's the leverage that they have on advertisement. Of course, the tier 2, tier 3 are a lot lower, but it's still a sizable amount. So I would like to see the exhibitor retain his share, what he deserves in the business, which is why he's in the business. Coming back to integrators like ourselves, at the end of the day, we are here to make a profit. We are all here for business. But that profit can't be in perpetuity. It can't be that the VPF never expires, the ownership is always with me, and everybody else in the circle is on the receiving end except for us. We've tried to get away with that model, and no offense to anybody in the business who works like that, to each one their own really. But the way I would like to position this is, we want a profit, we're transparent on what it costs us. This is the benefit that we have after cost recoupment, overheads, and all that. And that's a number that we all agree to. It's purely a yield business. It's a debt business. It's not a business for me as an integrator to take advantage of a situation where an exhibitor can't afford the equipment. The producer, of course, wants to have the best release, save cost. It benefits everybody. But I can't be at an advantageous position and take benefit of that all my life. So we at Crayon, in the plan that we have, is very clear. We have an X investment on equipment. We have a Y return, which is defined. Yes, there are business risks, a number of releases, number of VPF turns. But at the end of the day, my role gets over. It stops. You know, it's back to business as usual. Everyone transitioning. Digital is here to stay for life, and we are pretty much done. Beyond that, if the exhibitor chooses to work with me as an ad consolidator, as a service company selling consumables, as lamps, as filters, or whatever, those are ancillary businesses that are de facto created out of me being in the business itself. And that's a choice that the exhibitor has. So I think between the producer, exhibitor, the advertising agent, and the integrator, this is the level of equilibrium that I would like to set in the industry with my plan. And I think at the end of the day, if all stakeholders think what is in it for them and does this make sense, I think it will. I've tried to cover every aspect and looking at everyone's individual scenario in isolation, and hence Crayon has come up with a plan that we think is fair to the industry and will add a lot of value. Thank you so much.
Good evening, everybody. Speech is actually to hear such lovely things from my friend, what vision he has, what he plans for the exhibition sector to grow forward, the growth for the entire fraternity, from the production sector to the distribution and exhibition sector. I feel this is a path-breaking plan, and it's music to my ears, because you know the mindset of yesterday, unfortunately, without naming people, was very regressive in our country. And here comes a person who's talking things which are so transparent about the general health, who understands that if in case the producer is healthy, so will he be the integrator, and so will be the exhibitor, and so will be the distributor. This understanding for mutual survival, unfortunately, does not exist in our industry. That's why we were bleeding for so many years. So now, better late than never, I feel as a senior member of the Guild, being a former president of the Guild, I welcome this initiative taken by Mr. Ranjit Thakur. I applaud him for this decision of going into this venture. And Guild would definitely support him, and whatever support it needs. We welcome an initiative taken by you. And I will personally speak to each and every member, colleague in my fraternity, that we should applaud and give you all the support that is needed for you to to achieve your goal. I feel that's a brilliant opportunity which you have spoken about in terms of advertising, sharing to the exhibitor. The plan looks so fair, you know, and at the end of it, it has to be a win-win situation for it to last. And this is the only way it can last. So, thank you very much for giving this plan. I feel that this is a welcome sign for the industry. And if we have to grow, this is the way forward. We need to do it on a war footing. And I'm sure that with this initiative, a beautiful dawn is at the end waiting for us. Thank you.
Hi, good evening. The reason why I'm here on the stage with my distinguished colleagues is that Ranjit touched upon this point, saying we're probably the only country on which we play films on the e-cinema format. I think the future lies in digital, or we should, as producers, as studios, play more and more content, play more and more of our films on the digital cinema platform. And what is required is a transparent system wherein the box office reporting comes back to us transparently, films are being played in a fair manner, and it's a win-win for everyone. The key being sunset. There is a term in our business which is called sunset, that is, you do not pay PPF. It's like paying an EMI for a car after 5 years of using the car. We cannot keep paying this EMI, so to say, forever, and thereby our cost of distribution stays higher and higher. The future is how we can bring down costs, and such initiatives will bring distribution costs down considerably. So I think it's a great initiative and we completely support it. Thank you.
I represent Producers Guild of India. Let me share with you the mandate we have. India is the probably one of the lowest in terms of screen density. You know, our numbers, although we keep talking about anything between 10,000 to 12,000, and we have an example of China, where the number of screens have probably touched across 50,000. Dangal, which is one of our biggest Hindi films, you know, does X amount of business in India, and the same film, being a foreign film, does 4 times more business in China as a foreign film. And it's only because of the two things. One is the width of distribution. They have 55,000 screens to cater to cinemas. Secondly, I think the quality of projection, where the 2K becomes extremely important, is something which we need to adapt. You know, the challenges we have been facing over the years is how do we increase the market size? And the market size can only increase when the business becomes viable. We can't keep making films, and India makes about 2,000 films, and 5%, 10%, we don't have the exact number, because Neeraj talked about the transparency. We don't have a data which can tell us how many films have done, what kind of real numbers, and how profitable they have been. But the fact is, the majority of the films don't make money. And one of the reasons the films don't make money is the cost of distribution. We have a challenge. My friend is here who keeps talking about ticket pricing in India. Ticket pricing is also a function of, I think, it's a competition which is limited. Unless you have more number of screens in the country and the cinemas compete with each other, the prices will not come down. Unless you provide accessibility to the audience, the price point will always be a kind of a challenge. So coming back to the what Ranjit has talked about, and I must compliment the kind of plan he has, is that we need quality. Hence, 2K is minimum requirement we should look at. World market probably will be growing beyond 2K. I'm sure some of the markets have even better and higher technology. At the same time, the cost for the producer, as Neeraj rightly said, that you can't keep paying EMI for perpetuity for a property you have invested in. So the cost of the equipment has to be taken care of. Thereafter, one can always work on a model which is more as a service provider, which is only to a logistics requirement. If you go back to the earlier days when the 35 mm prints were there, you know, and then we shifted to digital, the understanding given to us was that the cost of distribution would come down, but the fact remains that for us as producers, the cost has not come down. We still incur 20,000-25,000 rupees as a VPF charge, which is not viable to sustain for a longer period. Either the films will not do well because the cost will keep increasing. At the same time, the business will not be viable. Hence, limited investment will come in this sector, and we will remain at an average of 6-8% market growth year after year, which is peanuts compared to the potential this industry has. So, as Mukeshji rightly said, that as Guild, we will support this to the best possible. And I've already mentioned to Ranjit that as soon as he is ready with the plan, we will take this to the industry at large and share with them. We'll have more buy-in from people to work together on this, and so that we can invest in the quality, we can have more cinemas who can be converted from A to B, and business become more viable from all the stakeholders. It is a win-win for everyone. It is not that the producers would make more money here. It's all about a win-win situation for all the three important players, which is producer, distributor, and exhibitor. End of the day, let's not forget the consumer. He gets to see our expensive, well-shot film in a better technology. Let's not deprive them. Thank you.
So, I'm not distinguishing in the plan between a single screen exhibitor or a multiplex exhibitor. The cost of the equipment that we put in both scenarios are obviously the same. The VPF that we are charging the production, and for the time period is of course the same. Single screens would be able to get an opportunity to play Hollywood content, a better quality on screen, eventually have a better experience for their consumers. We understand that ticket costs are a challenge for single screens, but at the end of the day, if they want to stay in business, they have to keep up pace with today's times of technology, the representation that they have on screen, and satisfy the consumer with the best cinematic experience that they could potentially get. With the equipment being the same that we are giving to them, it's the same experience that he would get in A scenario versus B scenario. I mean, look at, I have in the audience Sameer Joshi, the owner of Chandan. The experience at Chandan Cinema from a projection sound perspective is exactly the same that he has that we have next door in the PVR. That's the position that you want to get every single screen up right up there. And this is primarily a plan to upgrade the single screens from non-DCI, convert them to DCI, and help them participate in the overall business and the overall digital gamut that digital cinema provides for all stakeholders.
Recent multiplex controversies, do you have any opinion on that?
I don't know why, I actually don't have an opinion. I like to stay out of that question, by the way.
This is a platform to ask a question. We are fixing the issues. We should stick to this path breaking initiative, taking permission that we talk about creating a new way of increasing 2K inner DCI compliance in more cinemas for growth. Let's not get into the other issues, which is not a platform for that. See, it is going to be path breaking because you are talking about the standards set up by Hollywood studios for the DCI compliance, and that is what we want to take it forward. The quality of projection in our country, unfortunately, is not according to the world standards. We are making films which are, I can today say that our quality of technicians are brilliant, and we are making top class films in terms of its quality content is concerned, but we don't have the right exhibition arm for our projections to be done on international standards. So this is what is the need of the hour, and I feel with having this 2K compliance, we will achieve what the world has been delivering to the consumers for years. Unfortunately, our consumers, as Kulwit rightly pointed out, the quality of enjoying the movie-going experience in our country, unfortunately, is not as much as it is desired to be. And with this coming in, it will make one hell of a difference. I can assure you that.
Yeah, the entire solution, projector, server, all combined. No, I think the Samsung Onyx, ironically, PVR just made a press release today for their first Samsung screen. It's right up there. It has a limitation of screen size. It's a brilliant experience on screen in terms of visual. It's very, very expensive. We're talking of 2K systems here, which are obviously less than 1/10 of the cost of the Onyx. So that's not going to be for mass market. That's not something what we are here to deploy. We will deploy the standard 2K or 4K system.
The option would be available.
Yes, absolutely.
I have one question. 15 or 12 years ago, when I was consulting to Nimbus, I distributed Kalyog for Mr. Mukesh Bhatt along with Rajesh Thadani. And that was one of the first times that we had gone digital. We had gone, Rajesh and I went to the Central Plaza to see UFO's projection of Kalyug, and we were quite amazed that there was no film, there was no projector, it was just a server. At that time it was, we were told by the Central Plaza people that half has to be paid by the distributor, the other half is paid by the exhibitors, 250 rupees per show. And as the cost of the equipment is recouped, we will have to stop paying that, finally. Which we thought was one of the most brilliant things, that from that day to 25,000 rupees per screen. And I'm asking this for the education of the people in the press who don't know the backstory. How did, instead of it becoming free at some point, did it go from 300 rupees per show to 22,000 rupees? Anyway.
So I think, yeah, this is the big mystery, and that is where Sunset becomes key. You know, as studios, we keep making films, you know, producers like Mr. Bhatt keep making films. But the question we keep asking is, technology is supposed to make life better, cheaper, efficient. But if costs keep on escalating or stay where they are, then it's not benefiting anybody in the system. And hence it is very important that if you have a piece of, so let me compare it to a phone. If you're using a smartphone and it comes with a certain cost, then after a certain point in time you will upgrade it. What we are saying is that let's keep a minimum standard of 2K. India is very unique. We are the only country which does not play films only on 2K. It plays on 2K as well as non-2K. Let us have an entry barrier. Let's have a starting point. It's just 2K. Now, all films will play. It's more secure. We are currently making films of 40 crores, giving open files to our integrator friends. Luckily, that, I mean, things have been going fine, but can you imagine your 40 crore investment film, you're just handing over an open file to somebody. That's the biggest threat. 2K gives you security. There are less people handling the content. It's like a closed file handed over to the integrator. An integrator then just distributes. Worldwide, that's the way things operate. I think we all need to, that's why I move away from e-cinema. Move to 2K projectors. But, like I said, I'm paying an EMI, but I can't keep paying EMI till Kingdom Come. The benefits of us paying for the new projectors which get deployed in cinemas, that benefits needs to come back to the producers, whether it is from 4 years or 5 years or 8 years. But that benefit needs to start coming, which is not coming in. This becomes very critical of a sunset that comes wherein, I think 24 is what we were looking at by 2024. Post that, any filmmaker who wants to make a film does not have to worry about paying a distribution fee or a distribution cost. And thereby put in that money either in marketing it or producing it. Same of those costs.
Mr. Makkar, you mentioned the ratio of actors in comparison to China. When do you see the figure in India coming on par with China, and how can we achieve that?
See, unless and until, there are many reasons for cinemas to be the way they are in India. Viability is one issue. Regulations from the government are another issue. It's a very tedious process to open cinema hall in most of the states in the country. China growth story is only because the government had the mandate. They decided on their own that they will make Chinese film industry the largest film industry in the world. They wanted to overtake Hollywood. So the investment went into cinema building. And what they have done, which is very interesting, is that the cinemas are being built in smaller towns. If you look at India, probably we are leaving out a large population of the audience. We are not able to provide them experience of viewing cinema on a big screen in smaller towns. Because the investment is an issue, similarly the ticket price also, you know, kind of related to the investment you make in a cinema hall. We keep blaming multiplexes at times that why ticket prices are expensive, but the fact remains also they're very expensive, plush cinemas, and a lot of money had gone in. What we are arguing for is create cinema halls for every price point, every section of the society. Give them quality which probably they will view in a multiplex, give them on a single screen, but give it an affordable price. So that affordability can come in when there is a plan, there is a strategy which will benefit everyone. So the number of screens in India can only grow when business becomes viable, when competition is created. I know what your question about the controversy you wanted to talk about, but that's my answer to that would be that's only lack of competition. I'm against regulations being imposed on anyone for that matter, on prices. It is not the healthy situation for any business that the government regulates the price. Only way to answer and make things affordable would only be create options, create competition, let consumer choose where to watch it. So, I mean, one initiative which Ranjit spoke about, we are working with the government to simplify regulations. We are working with the government to incentivize investments in cinema building. There are, you know, new initiatives which have started on cinema, moving cinemas, because the real estate in India is a very expensive proposition. So there are moving cinema concepts which are coming in, moving into smaller towns. So unless we have that experience to a common man at a price which they can afford, so it's all about accessibility and affordability. That will answer everything for them.
Questions, guys?
I have a question. Question for Ranjit. You certainly implied that you had some support from the Hollywood studios for your program. Can you elaborate on that a little bit?
Hollywood studios had signed BPF agreements with some integrators in the past, Scrabble, and I was working with the Scrabble plan. I have full support from the Hollywood studios on a VPF plan that would inculcate pure conversions of non-DCI to DCI. That's the only time that Hollywood is willing to reopen the can of worms and potentially pay a VPF again for a certain fixed number of years, provided it increases their footprint. Hollywood wants an opportunity to participate in the whole gamut of screens available at the 12,500 screens in India, which currently there are only 4,500 give or take DCI screens. Because the footprint will increase, the tentpole movies that come from Hollywood are dubbed in all the languages. They want an opportunity to be able to play in these towns which don't have DCI systems currently. Just for that reason, the day and date release, the extended footprint, I'm in advanced discussions with Hollywood to sign a new VPF plan with me for the conversions of non-DCI to DCI.
Thank you.
Yes, Ranjit.
टूके और 4K में ये फर्क है कि 2K means 2 million pixels on screen and 4K means 4 million pixels on screen. So when you see 4K,
you will see a better image, provided the content is mastered in 4K. So if you have a आपके घर में टीवी होगा जो 2K है, लेकिन आप 1080p content feed करोगे तो आपको 2K का resolution नहीं दिखाई देगा, because your source file is in an inferior format. So you can't enhance the source file. If the source file अगर common रहता है 4K with 4K, आजकल Netflix, Amazon Prime has a lot of 4K content. Which you see in a 4K TV, you'll actually make out the skin tone, the pixelation. There's a huge difference between a 2K, 2K and 4K presentation.
लेकिन मैं यही कहना चाहूँगा कि आज हमारी requirement 2K की है. आज एक 2K screens अगर हमारे start हो जाते हैं और 2K projection system शुरू हो जाते हैं, that itself is a big achievement. Because हम फिलहाल जो फिल्में चल रही हैं हमारे कुछ theaters में, वो 2K नहीं है. जैसे इनका सवाल था कि हॉलीवुड की फिल्में हिंदी, तमिल, तेलुगु में डब होती हैं, लेकिन ये फिल्में सिर्फ 2K में चलती हैं. तो आज की तारीख में अगर किसी तमिल एग्जीबिट जो तमिल फिल्में चलता है एग्जीबिटर वो एक वीक है, जिसके अंदर उसके दो हफ्ते खाली रहने वाले, और कोई बड़ी हॉलीवुड की फिल्म आ रही है जो तमिल में चला सकता है, जो ऑडियंस को देखनी भी है, लेकिन जस्ट बिकॉज उसके पास 2K प्रोजेक्टर नहीं है वो फिल्म वहाँ नहीं चलती, क्योंकि सिक्योरिटी कंसर्न है. ऐसे नहीं कि देयर इज अ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन कि हमको ये थिएटर नहीं चला, क्योंकि एक लॉक फाइल होती है उसको आप खोल नहीं सकते. इस वजह से वो फिल्म वहाँ नहीं लगती है, और उस दो वीक के अंदर वो फिर वो कोई पुरानी फिल्म चलाता है, गैप फिल्म चलाता है. बट अगर ये 2K प्रोजेक्टर्स लग जाते हैं तो वो एग्जीबिटर के पास ऑप्शन होगा जिसके अंदर वो हिंदी, तमिल, तेलुगु के अंदर जो हॉलीवुड की फिल्में हैं वो भी चला सकते हैं. तो बेसिकली इसके अंदर मार्केट ग्रो होगा, एग्जीबिटर को बेनिफिट ज्यादा.
Producers Council, they went up the down, but it's again bring down the cost of the DPM. Is the Producers Guild of